So finally I'm back to do another complete artist collections video, but today's one's going to be pretty cool because it's two in one. So hello and yes, welcome back to another video, and as I said, today it's going to be another complete artist collection video, and for this one, mixed it up a little bit. I was looking at doing these artists individually, but then I thought, well, to be honest, they only have about 6 or 7 records each. So it really isn't a lot to show. And as they were in the same band, and of course they were in a relationship, and they're always kind of tied together, I thought I'd put them together for this video. So for this video, I'm going to be going over the one and only Lindsey Buckingham and Stevie Nicks. So, as I say, going to be going over just their vinyls today. Really, I don't have much else on them. I have 2 CDs on them, Seeds We Sow and Time Space from Stevie Nicks. But vinyl-wise, I'm missing a couple live albums from Stevie Nicks. I think one's called The House of Blues, their new releases, so not really anything too special. But when it comes down to studio albums and whatnot, I do own everything that's available on vinyl from these two individual artists. I'm not going to be including any Fleetwood Mac stuff here, we're just going to purely focus on the solo careers. So anyway, we're going to get started. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do Stevie Nicks first, then we're going to go over Lindsey Buckingham. So first up, Stevie Nicks, we've got her debut album here, Belladonna, which is an amazing record actually. And I was my very good friend in America, James Larpham, vinyl collector James, you know, an amazing guy in the VC who done an amazing video on Lindsey Buckingham's solo career actually. You know, he was very kind and he sent me this because he knew I was having a hard time finding this. And, you know, which is, you know, kind of strange because it is quite a common album, really. An 80s record here. I think it came out in the year 1980. 81, sorry. 1 year off. But, you know, it's cool to have an American pressing of this for sure. So this one's really nice. You get a nice inner sleeve with this one. All the lyrics. And then, very good condition actually, this one. So thank you, James, for sending me a nice one of this. This is really cool. And I remember it does sound really nice, this one. So that's really cool. It's a really good album actually. Has, of course, Stevie Nicks' most famous song on. That I probably would say that, including Fleetwood Mac stuff as well. Edge of 17 was a huge hit for Stevie Nicks. Put her solo career off to a great start. And of course you've got one of Tom Petty's most famous songs on here, who is another artist who I love, Stop Dragging My Heart Around. So you get 2 absolutely mind-blowing songs on here. And then you've got some other good stuff like Kind of Woman, Think About It, How Silly My Love. You know, there's some really good tracks on here, so it's a really nice album. Love the artwork, and I'm pleased to have an American copy because it's a nice thick card, which is always nice. So thank you, James, for helping me get that one. So that starts off the Stevie Nicks career there really well. And then, believe it or not, out of everything I have to show today, this was the last album I got. I had a lot of difficulty finding this for some reason. And it's not an expensive album. It's normally in that £5 to £10 range. But I didn't want to pay that for it. It's like an 80s album, a pretty common one. It's like, and I've heard a couple of people who I know find this in charity shops, you know, thrift store kind of things. So it's like, I'm just going to wait till I can get one for a good price. But anyway, for the sake of this video, in the end, I bit the bullet and bought one on Discogs for £2. Of course, you've got to tack on postage as well. But anyway, I finally got a copy of Wild Heart, Stevie Nicks here, of course. So I'm still pretty new to this album, so I can't really comment too much on it. But nonetheless, let's have a look. It's in pretty good condition, mine. And again, I can't remember. This might be... This one's made in Germany, this one. Because it did feel like slightly thicker card than UK. What we would use over here in the UK, because everyone knows we have loved to use like super thin paper. But on this album, there aren't really many I know. I know I Will Run To You because it has, again, Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers on. But the other ones on here, I'm not sure if I know any others on here, if I'm being honest. If Anyone Falls, that one rings a bell. Really need to give this one a proper play. But this one's nice because it's got its lyric sheet. And then the original inner sleeve there. which was really nice. You know, a bit of wear on this, but as I said, it's an 80s album. It's pretty common. I'm sure if I want to, eventually I'm going to find a nice upgrade copy on this, I'm sure. We're going with this side. Needs a bit of a dust, but other than that, it's in really good condition, this one. Yeah. So, again, really nice album here. I have yet to really get to know the music, but, you know, that early Stevie Nicks 80s stuff, it's just kind of so easy listening. It's not the best music out there, don't get me wrong. I don't think it's, you know, it's not like mind-blowing stuff, you know, but it's just fun, innocent stuff, you know. It's really fun to listen to, and it just reeks of 80s Fleetwood Mac as well. So if you like 80s Fleetwood Mac, especially the Stevie songs, then you're definitely going to enjoy her solo career. So next one up, this is where everything gets a bit more interesting, because from here on out, my Stevie Nicks collection gets really nice, because, you know, the first two are great, don't get me wrong, but, you know, they're just used common copies, whereas my next ones are, I've been very lucky with, and actually I found a couple of these at a car boot, which was amazing. So I found this one at a car boot, Rock a Little. But as you can see, this one here is still in its shrink, which is really nice. Slit down the side though. But I found it at car boot, and it's still, I kept the sticker on, Canadian import, £3. I don't know why I kept the sticker on, but it's still there. So anyway, got the sticker here, including the hit Talk to Me. And yeah, really nice condition, this one, really good. So anyway, you know, Talk to Me, big hit. The Nightmare, I thought, I really like that song actually, that's a really good one. Again, you know, this album here, I'm not hugely familiar with it, but it's, I remember enjoying this one a lot. Let's have a look at this one. The previous seller of this, because I bought two records off him, and the other one you will see in this video, you know, took really good care of the records I bought off him, and again, it's just nice, thick card, which is really nice, you know. As you said, shrink, in pretty good condition now on the side. You know, I'm not much of a person who seeks out records in shrink, but over here, because over here in the UK, it's so rare to get them in shrink, where I see a lot of people like me, Mr. Mayo, who actually get really, you know, he seems to find loads of shrink records. It just seems like in America, it was a lot more common, so it's really cool to find a shrink record over here, I find. But anyway, the record itself is in great condition, and the label's cool, so really nice there. Of course, you get all the lyrics on the inner sleeve. And the inner sleeve is in really nice condition as well. So, slide that one back in. So yeah, as I say, you know, it's just always super cool and fun to find a record in shrink here, because it's they're just not common in shrink here. But as I say, I don't go out my way to find them, but when I do find them, it's just always really nice. You know, it's just makes the records look a lot better, right? I find. So anyway, there's that one. Next one up is completely sealed, haven't opened it. And again, really, really rare in the UK. And this is The Other Side of the Mirror. And this one I actually found on eBay. So I got it for about £7, I think. Didn't pay much at all, but yeah, completely sealed, haven't opened it. Has got a cut in there. So anyway, you know, we've got Contains the Hit, Rooms on Fire. And again, I can't say I'm hugely familiar with this one, but I remember really liking the last track, I Still Miss Someone, and it's got blue eyes. But there's another couple on here, Alice and Cry Wolf, that was pretty good, I remember. But again, and I can't remember these albums hugely off the top of my head. I'm sure there's people out there who can do a much better job at talking about them than me. But, you know, it's just really cool to have a sealed copy of this. And then, of course, from that same seller at the car boot, I managed to get a copy of it in shrink, which was slit down the sides. So this is my plain copy, but it's still in shrink, which is pretty awesome if you ask me. And yeah, as you can see, same seller there, kept the sticker on and everything. And really, you know, just nothing different about it, but I think there's this one doesn't have a sticker on the corner, whereas this one, Give the Gift of Music, not sure what that's about, maybe from an old record store or something where the previous owner bought it. But yeah, fantastic. Again, this is a Canadian import, and I'm pretty sure the other one is too. Let's crack it open and have a look. Forget what you get inside this one, if I'm being honest. I don't, You couldn't tell, I don't really pull these ones out too often, but anything else in there? Nope, again, nice thick card though, which I like. get a nice lyric sheet in there again. Nice inner sleeve. Oh, look at that, jeez. That needs maybe a bit of glue, but it's the back. And record, again, needs a bit of a dust, this one. I haven't played it in a while, but the record label's cool. So anyway, let's slide that one back in. Shame about the inner sleeve there being split at the bottom, but other than that, this I've done incredibly well on this album, I'd say. All I need now is a nice reissue of it to play. But whether these albums are get reissued or not, I don't know. I'm not too hopeful that these ones will, but it'd be nice. It'd be very nice if they did reissue them, because obviously now after this album, I'm missing her whole middle chunk of her catalogue on vinyl, because it's never been put out on vinyl. So there is one album I'm missing, and it's the compilation. It's The Space, is that what it is? I think it is. Time Space. So this one here is available on vinyl as well, but it goes for about £40, and for a compilation I just can't do it. But anyway, so of course I'm missing the albums in the middle there because they haven't been put out on vinyl, but I'm hopeful that they will be one day. But then of course I did buy her latest album, which is quite a title really. Stevie Nicks, 24 Karat Gold, Songs from the Vault. Wasn't sure if I was going to like it. You know, there's 16 tracks on here. It's really packed full of songs. And I wasn't sure, you know, I thought, well, maybe Stevie's had her day. But played it and I loved it. This was a great record. Really did enjoy it. So this is a fantastic album here from Stevie. Highlight songs, I really can't give you highlight songs because there's, you know, 16 tracks on here. It's really jam-packed. And to be honest, they were all really good. There weren't really any bad ones on here. So, yeah, this is a good one. I really enjoyed it. Yeah, let's have a look. I really can't remember what you get in here, to be honest. I don't think you get a download card. But anyway, let's have a look. Looks like just plain records in here. But anyway, we'll pull one of them out. So there we go, you get a nice lined sleeve. Really nice. So yeah, done a good job on that one. It is a gatefold, but of course I've only slit the sides because it's not that tight actually getting the records in. The only time I ever take shrink off records, gatefold wise, is when the records are too tight. And this one here isn't too tight, so I'm going to leave the shrink on. Slide that back in. And then I got one more album to show from Stevie, and I wouldn't have bought this when it came out, because Amazon still want like £25 for it. And as it's a compilation, I just don't see it. But I found this as a Bite Now, brand new from Germany, and the postage was free, I remember, for like £8. I was like, for a brand new record, double vinyl and clear vinyl? How could I turn that down? So I got Crystal Visions, the compilation, which, if you're getting into Stevie, you don't really know Stevie well, and you only want to get maybe one album from her. The compilation from the 90s is so rare and so expensive. This is the one to get. Just pick this up, because this is amazing. You know, it has Edge of 17, has the Tom Petty songs. It actually has a song with Fleetwood Mac, the rest of the band. Has a few live performances. You know, this is fantastic. And this one here, it comes with an insert, but I don't think it came with a download code. Let's have a look. Yeah, see, this one's really, really thick card. But anyway, what I do is, this one could actually do with coming out of shrink, if I'm being honest, because it's really quite, it's a little bit tight. But anyway, see, this one here is on clear vinyl. Really nice labels. So, yeah, you know, when I go to Stevie, if I want to hear a bit of Stevie, I find this compilation here is a bit short anyway, so I never put the CD on, really. This is what I go to when I want to hear some Stevie. Most of the time, you know. This one or her last album, which, as I say, you know, give it a chance, because I know a lot of people probably were thinking what I was initially thinking, you know. I'm not sure I'm going to like this, but check out her new album if you haven't. If, you know, don't lose faith in her, because really, she's actually still very good. So anyway, that's my Stevie Nicks collection there. Now we're going to move on to Lindsey Buckingham. But before we move on to Lindsey Buckingham, I thought I'd chuck this album in between Lindsey and Stevie. That, of course, is Buckingham Nicks. So the two of them together on an album from 1972, I believe. I believe it's 72, but don't quote me. It's early 70s for sure. I think it might be 73, actually, now I think about it. But, you know, this is a masterpiece. Masterpiece. I was very lucky to get this in from America for a very, very affordable price. Because normally this one goes for big bucks. So, and here's the record. Of course, got Polydor here. This is a non-gatefold edition, so I don't think it's as rare as the gatefold one. And it's a 1980s pressing, I believe. But as I'm not fussed. I don't really care for having an original here. Because it's in good condition and it plays fine. That's all I need. So I was over the moon to get this. And this is a great album. If you love Rumours and the self-titled Fleetwood Mac, this is the album to get. This is the next album for you to check out. Because it sounds just like them. If you like them too, you're going to like this. This is great. So anyway, now we're moving on to Lindsey Buckingham. And I have actually talked about Lindsey Buckingham quite a few times on my channel. Did review his album Go Insane recently. So anyway, let's get started. So the first album up by Lindsey Buckingham, of course, is Law and Order, which actually is a really good album. This one's a little bit underrated because everyone kind of goes to Go Insane or Out the Cradle. Whereas for me, I really like this album. I'm not saying it's better than Go Insane or Out the Cradle, because they are both great albums, but this album here just doesn't get enough attention, I don't think. So, nice gatefold there. And you get a nice... Did you get an inner sleeve on this one? No, you don't. And there's the record label on this one. Yeah, if you like Fleetwood Mac, you know, Stevie Nicks, a lot of people... Look at that, needs a good dust, don't it? A lot of people do tend to check Stevie out because she did have quite a big success with her solo career. But Lindsey, unfortunately, never had a huge success with his solo career. So a lot of people don't check him out. But I would really, really highly recommend that you do go check him out because, you know, his solo career really is amazing. Really is. This one doesn't want to go back in the sleeve. There we go. So the next album up, again, I was very, very lucky because I got this record from my amazing friend in the US, of course, James Larpin, vinyl collector James again. So James, once again, mate, you know, thank you so much, you know, for sending me these because this is amazing, really is. Another sealed copy. And this is, of course, for Lindsey Buckingham's Go Insane. Now, I know James is a huge fan of this album, so he really wanted me to get a nice copy of it. And he sent me the best copy ever, because it hasn't even been slipped, this one. So this is in such nice condition. And then what James did as well, of course, been so amazing. He sent me an opened copy for me to play. So this is my playing copy. But, you know, it's so amazing, so nice of you to do that, James. So thank you so much again. But anyway, you know, this album here, I have reviewed it. So if you want to see me go over it in more detail, please go check out the review. It's not too far back on my channel. But, yeah, you get a nice inner sleeve with this one. And there's the record. So really, Lindsey starts to go a little bit more experimental here. It doesn't sound like your typical 80s stuff. So, really, really interesting record there. So, yeah, I'd highly recommend checking that one out, that's for sure. Fantastic album. Okie dokie. Three to go. We're nearly there. So, next one up, of course, is probably the most rare record I have to show. And I was very lucky to get a hold of this. This is Out the Cradle by Lindsey Buckingham. Released in 92, this one. And this really is a phenomenal album. The CD is affordable, so I'd really recommend checking this one out on CD. If you want the vinyl, you are looking at about probably good, close to £100. It's not a common record to come by. Now, got it's inner sleeve, the original inner sleeve here. I did keep it all because it's worth so much. But I put the record in one of these bags because I really wanted to protect it. So, and it's in very good condition, this one. So really nice, really, really am so lucky to have this, really am. So really, this is one of the most valuable and coolest records in my collection. Only complaint is it's paper thin, as they were in the 90s, but hey, that's just the way things are. Slide that one in as well. So probably the coolest record in this video here. So it really is amazing. So lucky to have this. An amazing record there. Then of course Lindsey's middle album, which I think is called Under the Skin, if I'm correct, is not available on vinyl yet. I kind of doubt that one will get put out on vinyl, but hey, fingers crossed it does at some point. So anyway, now we're going to skip to Gift of Screws, which is also a pretty good album. This one's not my favourite Lindsey album. There's a few good tracks on here. I do like the song Great Day, Love Runs Deeper, but there's a track on here which I can't stand. Time, Precious Time. There. But anyway, this is a great album. Comes with a download code. Have a look at it. I believe this one was actually only printed in Canada. Just kind of interesting. And you do get an insert in here, but really just lyrics on it, so I'll leave that in there. But get the CD, not download code, CD with this one, which is cool. I kept the sticker on my Blake sleeve there. This one doesn't come shrink, it comes in one of them baggy sleeves, which I hate. But anyway, so there's that one. Go back in the sleeve. There we go. And now, last one. And in my opinion, I've saved the best one till last. Out of all the records I've showed today, this is my favourite one. Seeds We Sow by Lindsey Buckingham. This is my favourite Lindsey album. I play this album a lot, hence why I bought it on CD. I love the song Seeds We Sow, In Our Own Time, Illumination, That's the Way That Love Goes, Rockaway Blind, One Take, and End of Time. They're my favourites on here. This is, you know, this album's so cheap as well. It's a double vinyl. It's only like £15-20 on Amazon. So if you're going to buy anything after watching this video, please, please, please check out this album because it's so good. It really is an amazing record. And, you know, if you need more convincing of why you should get it, it's on a red vinyl, which is really nice. So yeah, as I say, if you're going to take anything away from this video, just check it out on Spotify. Go, just check this album out. It's so good. And his guitar playing on it is amazing. This is why Lindsey Buckingham has to be one of my favourite guitarists. Just amazing, amazing musician. So anyway, that's it for this video there. So as I say, if you want to take anything away from this video, this album, and I'd probably say Crystal Visions by Stevie Nicks. And of course, Buckingham Nicks, the album when they're together. That's a nice little trio there, I think. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget, my contest is still going on if you want to get involved in that. I've had some great entries since the contest reminder, so thank you for everyone who's taken part. And yeah, that's it for this video. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Tell me I must keep away, away.